If you use Excel, you'll inevitably need to link sheets in a workbook. The most common way to link cells from different sheets is by using the equal sign. To do this, type the equal sign where you want to create your link, go to the sheet that has the cell you want to link to, and press enter. Because the sheet we are linking to is in the same workbook, the link created is a relative link. You can tell this because there are no dollar signs in the linked cell formula. This means that to link to the other values in group 1, I can drag this down to link to the cells below the original cell that we linked, then drag it to the right to include the cells to the right. A faster way that you can create a link is by using the paste link feature. So go to the sheet with the cells that you want to link to, copy them, and let's go back to our summary sheet. Place your cursor in the location where you want your link, right click, and then paste special. You can either select the icon with the links or click paste special and select paste link. And you can see up here in the formula bar how all of these values are actually linked to those same cells in the group 1 tab. So something to note here is that the formatting on our linked cells is not the same as in the original values that we linked to. So just know that you'll need to take that extra step to format your linked cells. You can also create links to named ranges. So let's go over to the Group 1 tab and we'll select all of the data, and then up here in the name box, we'll just call it Group 1, press enter, and then each time we select the Group 1 named range, all of this data will be selected. So once you've done that, you can go back to the summary tab and type the equal sign and begin typing the named range. So here's Group 1, we can select that, press enter to populate all of the contents of that named range. So something to note, this type of linking works a little different than the other methods. With my active cell inside the named range that we linked, notice that you see a light blue border around those linked cells. To keep the cells in the named range together, this type of linking actually creates a group that can't be separated. Notice if I try to delete any of them, I'm not able to do so. However, if I try to change any of these values, I lose the entire linked range and I end up with an error. You can also link to other cells by creating a hyperlink. So this won't show you the values from the cells that you're linking to, but it will let you jump to that location. To do this, just place your cursor wherever you'd like to place your hyperlink and right click and select link, or press Ctrl K from your keyboard. And then here, let's go to a place in this document. And from this section, you can select either the sheet that you'd like to link to, or if you have a defined name, you can select that and jump straight to that section. But for this example, let's just select the Group 1 sheet. So whenever you select a sheet to link to, it's going to default to jumping to cell A1 of that sheet. And you can see that here in the cell reference. If you want to jump to a different location in that sheet, you can update that cell location here. But I'm going to leave that as is for now. And then up here in the text to display, you can either leave this as is or you can create a friendlier name for your link. So we'll say Group 1 link, and then press OK when you're done. And now whenever you click on that link, you'll automatically go to that location. So what if instead you want your links to total the values for the groups or do some other calculation? We can again link the cells by using the equal sign and then adding a plus sign between each. So we link to the first value in Group 1, add a plus sign, then go to Group 2 and select the corresponding value to create the calculation, and then press enter. Let's expand this a little. So then, like before, we can drag this over and down to populate the rest of the link calculations. So instead of using a bunch of plus signs, you can also use a function to calculate your linked values. For example, let's type equals sum, open parentheses, in Group 1, select the first cell, add a comma, go to Group 2, and select the corresponding cell there. And you would keep doing this if you have other sheets that you're combining, and press enter when done. And then like before, we can just drag this over and down to populate the rest of our calculations. Another way you can sum link values is by creating a 3D formula. So 3D formulas reference the same cell or range of cells across multiple sheets. So if all the values you are summing are in the same cell locations in all the sheets you're referencing, then you can use a 3D formula. Take a look. This time we'll type equals sum again. We'll go to the Group 1 tab, select the first cell, and while holding down the Shift key, select each of the other tabs that you want to include in the calculation. So I only have one tab here, but if you have more, select those, and then press Enter when done. And again, we can copy over and down to populate the rest of our calculation. You can also calculate values across sheets by consolidating them. To consolidate, you'll need to make sure that the cell ranges you're selecting are laid out the same way. They don't have to be in the exact same location like they did for the 3D formula, but they do need to have the same type of data and layout. Let's delete these. And you'll find the Consolidate feature in the Data tab under Data Tools section, and here click Consolidate. So the first thing you need to do is select the type of calculation that you want. For this example, we're using the sum, and then we need to select the cell ranges that we're going to be consolidating. Here in the reference section, I'm going to go to Group 1 and select the values and the labels. Come back here, click Add, and come to Group 2 and select the second group of data to consolidate and click Add to that. So next, if we want for Excel to label the results for us, we can select that here. I know I want to use the headers along the top of my data, and there was no labels in the left column, so I'll leave that blank. Next, you need to select if you want to create a link to the original data or not. If not, click OK, and you'll only see a result of the calculation that you selected. So the Consolidate feature saves your consolidation, so you can go back to it, and if we want to create links to the source data, we can go back and do that. Now, when you select to link the source data, your results will be automatically grouped. And once you have your results, you can then ungroup each to see what cells the links are pointing to. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.